Plastic is everywhere. It's in everything. Your phone, this camera, landfills, mountains, the forest, the beach, the ocean, sea turtles, so many fish. It's everywhere. Hey there, gas guzzlers. Trace here for DNews. If you never had to take organic chemistry, then you just don't know the scourge that is carbon. It's in everything. Everything is a carbon-hydrogen chain. You spend your time moving electrons around, changing bonds, and hating life. Orgo is extremely important because basically all life contains the organic molecule carbon. I mean, molecularly, humans, plants, dogs, cats, pizza, pretty much everything contains carbon. The plastic polyethylene is a long chain of carbons and hydrogens, with some strong double bonds between chunks. Petroleum, it's also just a chain of carbons and some hydrogens. Both of these things are polluters, and both come from hydrocarbons of natural gas and crude oil. It might seem like alchemy, but what if there was a way to take all the hydrogens and carbons in crappy plastic and rearrange the atoms into the hydrogens and carbons of a fossil fuel? Guess what, fam? Now there is! This paper's blank. We just wanted to do something dramatic. Anyway, a 2016 paper in Science Advances announced they were able to turn polyethylene into energy, potentially solving two polluting problems with one variable. In their study, the researchers took plastic from bottles, food packaging, and shopping bags, recycling plastic numbers 2 or 6, and mixed it with a catalyst, breaking those long chains of hydrocarbon plastic into an alkane. Alkanes are a class of hydrocarbon. We often burn alkanes for energy, like methane, propane, or butane, for example. By their chemical calculation, they got 56% of the plastic to degrade into alkane oil products, namely diesel. Yep, these scientists were able to turn plastic shopping bags into diesel fuel with a waxy byproduct. That waxy byproduct can then be sold and used for resins and coatings, and the catalyst is reusable after the chemical reaction is completed, and of course you have diesel. But to be honest, this does feel kind of like alchemy, but it is needed. There are a lot of other plastics out there that we need to deal with. The polyethylenes in this process, remember, are only 2s or 6s, but there are dozens of other plastics that accumulate in landfills and oceans. According to the American Chemical Council, if we can figure out this trash-to-energy pipeline, it could create $9 billion in economic output and tens of thousands of new jobs. And they're not the only ones advocating for this. In Australia and the United Kingdom, various startups are converting polystyrene, plastic number 6, as well as 2s, 5s, and 7s, into biofuels. Global plastic production is ridiculous. In 2013, according to World Watch, 299 million tons of plastics were created. 10 to 20 million tons of that ended up in the ocean, with millions of tons ending up in landfills. In Europe, they found 26% of the plastics consumed were recycled, but in the US, only 9%. So take that polyethylene, for example. As a product, it comprises 60% of all the plastic trash in landfills. Once there, it breaks into smaller and smaller pieces, but never truly disappears. According to the Union of Concerned Scientists, when you pay for fuel, you're only paying for a little bit of the cost, both the fossil fuels themselves and also the side effects of the mining, extraction, transportation, and burning of those fuels harm the planet and the things living on it. This new process is still creating diesel, but it's not drilling, extracting, refining, and transporting it. So if we could break this fossil fuel chain by circling some of that back on itself, it would be huge. So back to this process. Could this solve our energy problems? Not yet. Though the researchers call this breakthrough unprecedented, the ability to change post-consumer plastics into diesel and waxes isn't as efficient as just getting new diesel. Yet. Currently, the ratio of plastic to catalyst in this process is 30 to 1. According to PhysOrg, the researchers' goal is 10,000 to 1. So while this may be the first step, there might come a day when we look to landfills for our fuel. How do you feel when someone throws away a recyclable thing? I mean, like, puts it in the trash, because I die inside. It makes me crazy. Tell us about it in the comments. Biodegradable plastics are the hot new thing, but how do they really biodegrade? Check this video to see the answer. And please subscribe so that we can keep talking science with you every day.